guys, what's popping and what's good? It's your girl Kunamaka in the building, and I'm back with another video. So if this is your first time coming across my channel, you're highly welcome. Please hit the subscribe button down below, and all my returning subscribers, you know how we do it. Welcome back to my channel.
The highlight for today is how Davido dropped out from school because of his music career. So let's jump right into today's out there.
Nigerian singer David Adeleke, popularly known as Davido Bades, has narrated how he went against his father's wish to become a musician. In one of his Instagram live video with Ubi Franklin, he narrated his road to fame, revealing that he skipped school for a whole year because of music. He said, and I quote, "When I say music, I didn't think it was going to go big. I was doing it just to do music. Over time, money started coming. My dad was a disciplinarian. I didn't even know my dad had that much money. I was on the run for like 3 months because my dad found out I was not in school for a whole year." Search the clip of his Instagram live video with Ubi Franklin.
"David, I know for a fact that your father was not in support of your music when you started, right? And I know one time he had come to, he posted you and your friends in a hotel where you guys were recording music, and he arrested all of you."
"Do you think like that? Yeah. Because I came back, I was on the road for like 3 months because he had found out that I was in a school.
Yeah.
I was in school for like the whole year before. Because I was meant to be, I did 1 year. Then I skipped the second year, so I was meant to be in third year, but I was actually in second year.
Yeah.
So I asked. So he found out I was not in school, and I was like, damn. I don't even know how I'm going to go home like this. They were calling my phone. I off my phone. I had no explanation. Because see, in second year of school, that's when I fell in love with music, so I was focusing on that. All the money he sent me, I used it to buy my first studio equipment. So I had like the best studio equipment in uni that time. So I was even just recording people. That's what I was doing first, recording people, learning how to engineer, learning how to produce. Then, I came to Nigeria for 1 December. And meanwhile, this December I'm talking about, this December I came and I hung out with Moet, because Pesta was working for them. Yeah. So I really rode with them and I saw everything like firsthand. Like, I was going to shows with them. Like, I saw, like, damn, these guys are really doing, these guys are really making money. Like, it's crazy. Like, I remember Jazzy and Banga pulling up with double Bentleys. Like, I remember seeing that. That was one of the first things. Like, I was like, damn, these niggas got Bentleys. Like, they're making money off this music. And I was like, oh, more, I can do it too. Then, I told my dad, I was like, dad, man, I think I want to stay in Nigeria. Can I transfer my classes to maybe Unilag or something? He blasted me. He said, what the fuck? What am I talking about? I better be going back to America. He even made me not go that night. So I'm on the plane. I'm coming off the plane in ATL, ready to go to immigration. My uncle is outside the airport waiting for me to take me to school, because my school was like 2 hours away from Atlanta, where the actual school was, the campus. Was 2 hours away. So I'm coming off the plane and somebody's on the phone saying, give me David's number. So I looked back, I just saw one day, we were on the same flight, bro, going back to ATL. I was like, Sha, what do you think they do for here? He's like, oh, mother, them, they're going to LA tomorrow. That Banga is coming, Banga and Jazzy are coming the next day. Then they're going to LA to shoot Snoop Dogg video. I was like, what? I was like, dog, are you not sure that video was Snoop Dogg? I said, man, I have to go to school. My uncle is outside. When he was like, yeah, your uncle is outside. And the band is coming tomorrow. I beg, I said, oh, fuck it. I'm off my phone. I tried immigration. Then I went to hide in the toilets. So when one day them, I told one day that these are my bag books. So he just collect my bag for me. The effort that me, I'll find my way, I'll take train or something. So I was in the toilet waiting. when he now called me, like almost like four people have come to him and said, sorry, that they're looking for Dr. Adeleke's son. That has yeah. seen any doctor. When he said, I don't know any Dr. Adeleke's son. As I ex, took the train. Ex, they were calling my phone. I didn't even pick. That is why my daddy now called school, because I turned off my phone. So my daddy now called school that he can't reach his son. The school told him that ourselves cannot reach David for the past 1 year. So, Facebook, I remember coming off the train, I was even starting to now. I even told one day, oh yeah, how much you bring come, make a nice hotel, babe, you go, what do you want to do tonight? All those kind hands. And I just see a message on Facebook from my cousin. Like, I just left from his office, so it'd be like saying, call your school, and they tell him to know this school for the past 1 year. I was like, what? And funny enough, the rule in my family is once you're in third year, you get any car, you get a car, a brand new car, for school.
Yes.
So at that time, Popsy just brought me one Audi Q7, brand new. So my plan was to get the car, sell the car,
yeah,
then come to Nigeria, then start my music team.
Bad boy.
So tonight, you know what I say, I'm all, God, I don't even know what was in my head. Like, I don't know what spirit took over me this period of my life. I was like 15, 16, bro. I went to my daddy's house in ATL, broke the back door, entered the house, unlocked the alarm. Open all the rooms, Jazzy came, Banga came, all of them stayed in the house.
Yeah.
I gave Jazzy, everybody just stayed in jail, everybody had one room. We partied, was going crazy. Then they left the next day.
Thank you guys so much for watching. If you watch this video this far, just know that I love you so, so much. And I hope you enjoyed that. I love you guys. See you.